Welcome to the Vinyl Buffet. I'm Cody. The purpose of this show is to chronicle my journey into vinyl. I've been a collector of records for a few years. I just didn't have a great way to play them. Last year, I lucked into some of the components you see behind me, and now I've created the Vinyl Buffet. For my setup, I'm using a Sony PSLX340 turntable with a VS-225EP Audio-Technica cartridge with a needle of undetermined age, but seems to be working out for me pretty well. Going to replace that soon. That feeds into the Sony AVU-270 receiver that I have. These are like mid-80s components that I got used. Finishing it off with some Bose 6.2 stereo everywhere speakers, which sound really good considering their age and the kind of setup that I've got them hooked up to. I really enjoy the sound that comes out of them. Before I start talking about records, I want to talk about two of my favorite tools that I use. The first one is for the stylus. This is a little Turntable Lab stylus brush. Use that guy by putting it under the stylus, pulling it back towards you. It's got really fine, like carbon fiber bristles there, and that'll clean your stylus right up. If you see a lot of dust building up on the front of your cartridge, probably what's happening is your needle is blazing a trail through the grooves, and it is just kicking that dust and debris up onto that. That's a good sign that you probably need to clean your stylus. And this little brush does quite well for that. My second tool is this Audio-Technica anti-static record brush. I don't know so much about the anti-static qualities of it, but I do love the carbon fiber bristles. So what you'll do with this guy, basically before every play of every side, I will put this guy on and lift the tone arm on the turntable, drag this fella across it. Probably takes about 10 seconds maybe. I usually wait about 5 rotations. Sometimes I'm pretty generous depending on how much I see it picking up dust and buzz and everything else. Pulling it towards the center from, like, I would say 9 o'clock on the record, pulling that guy across and then lifting up, and that way bring off all the static and dust and everything with it. Just give it a nice little flip back and forth, and that'll kick all the dust off of it in another direction. And then usually record sounds a little bit better, depending on how much dust and crap it actually picked up. So I want to talk a little bit about the Vinyl Buffet show. The format is probably going to vary from show to show. I'm going to be talking about reviews of records, cleaning, care, that kind of stuff when it comes to records, purchases that I've made, stores that I like, all the other trappings of vinyl, really. It could be anything related to vinyl, and CDs and MP3s and music in general. Might be some live concert stuff that I talk about in the future. It really just depends. I'm really open to what this show will be. I'm going to try to keep it out on a regular basis. I'm going to try to make it interesting for people. So I've got a little treat before we go. I have this record that is sealed that I've had in my possession for a while now. It's Rush Moving Pictures. And what I'd like to do is open it. I'll tell you a little bit of the story of how I came to have this record as I'm opening it, because why not? Basically, there was this store in St. Louis that was an upcycle store that they take things that are seemingly about to go to the trash and save them, like scraps of fabric, maps. All right, so in this Murphy's Law first episode of the Vinyl Buffet, we had a little bit of difficulty. The camera ran out of space as I was recording this, so we'll just skip right to the playing of the record. So we have our Rush Moving Pictures that we're going to play. We're just going to hit side one, and I'm going to give you another glimpse into my cleaning technique. So right now I've got the tone arm lifted. I'm going to let the arm come around and engage before I start putting this on the record. And I'm just going to slowly put it on there. Let it make one turn, two turns, three turns, four turns, five turns. It looks like it's pretty much picked up everything. Just take it towards the spindle, and there we go. It left a little bit on the inner groove, but I'm just going to let it go. So let's hear how this record sounds. It pretty much sounds perfect, so I'm happy that I unsealed this record and am playing it, so I can have it for years to enjoy.